Please remain calm. Emergency services are on their way. We're sorry for the inconvenience.
Finally, I thought you'd never shut up.
Tell me about it. I'm off to station 3.
Ring 4 sealed off. It'll be fine, Mr. Anom.
Thank you, Doctor. You and your friend may just pull this off yet.
No need to thank us. It's sort of what we do.
It would be nice if for once I could just show my companion the sights instead of having to worry about evil robots or freak meteor storms. Yes, sorry about that.
Fat lot of good, the record for largest mole ever will get you if this place gets vented into space. Where else needs securing?
Deck 3 seems to be the only place left damaged.
Dave's working on that now.
Station 3 calling the doctor. Station 3 calling the doctor.
We read you, Dave. How's Deck 3?
Stabilized. I think we've done it.
What was that?
Oh dear, I'm afraid the computers say it was the gravity matrix. It's overloading.
If that thing goes, it'll implode on itself and crush the station into nothingness. Is there something you can do to switch it off to allow it to reset?
Let me see. All the electronic systems are fried.
Wonderful.
However, there is an emergency manual switch inside the chamber itself. If someone went in there, they could use that switch to turn off the matrix and the system will reset.
I'll go, we're closer.
No one can go in there, that's the problem. Look at the radiation meter, it's leaking radiation.
I'll go in anyway. Do you have a radiation suit?
Of course, but at those levels it won't help much.
I can take it. A little radiation never hurt me. Well, never mind.
Doctor, you can't.
Yes, I can. I've the best chance of surviving, and I'm not letting 200,000 people die without at least trying. Show me the suit.
Doctor, you can't.
Yes, Dave, I can.
That room is also filling with gas. Forget the radiation. One spark and you die in a fireball, Doctor.
It's a risk I'm going to take, Dave. I was doing stuff like this long before I picked you up.
I kinda figured that.
It'll be easy, Dave. I just walk to the other side of the room and throw the switch. The gravity will go off long enough for the matrix to reset itself, and then everything will be fine.
I hope you're right, Doctor.
So do I.
Good luck, sir.
Don't call me sir.
Sorry. He's pulling the lever. The gravity matrix is offline. It's resetting itself. He did it! The doctor did! The room exploded! Doctor! What? Who are you?
Me?
I'm the doctor. Doctor? Doctor who?
Me. I'm the doctor. Same person that went into that room, but with some changes.
I'm very confused.
See, I'm a Time Lord. Whenever a Time Lord dies, we do this thing called regeneration. Our bodies heal themselves, but our appearance and personalities change in the process.
That's not the only thing that changes.
What do you mean?
Have you heard yourself? You sound like me!
I do.
Doctor. TARDIS. Belly button. Huh.
I guess I picked up on your accent during the regeneration process. What accent is this again?
Some sort of American accent?
Well, that's rubbish. I don't think there's been a single Time Lord that's ever used this accent. It's not sophisticated enough.
So, what happened again?
Well, I went in there and flipped a switch and saved everyone, but the room exploded and I was caught in a blast. Naturally, this killed me, so I regenerated. How do I look?
So, you actually died.
Yes, I thought I made it clear. Now, what color hair do I have? I'm not old again, am I? No, you've got brown hair and you look like you're about my age. Seriously? Ah, wonderful. I go from looking as ancient as I feel to being baby-faced again. Ah! What's wrong? Nothing, just the regeneration doing its thing. Now, would you like a jelly, baby? A what? Sorry, the personalities are a bit mixed up right now. My mind is trying to decide on who I'm gonna be now. Perhaps we should find you a place to rest. Yeah, that may be a good idea. Alonzi. Doctor? I'm fine. Just reversing the polarity of the Geronimo. What? We need to move him. I agree. This is Paul, checking in. The fire seems to be out here and minimal damage. Heading back. Oh, well, you're a tiny life form, aren't you? This meteor nonsense must have scared you stiff. Come on, you can come back with me. Come on. Well, he's still alive, so that's good. But who is he? He can't be the same man that went to that gravity chamber. I think he is. He was wearing the same suit. Well, the same hazmat suit, anyway. I don't know what happened to the blue one he was wearing when he went in there. Burned up, maybe? How could it have burned up inside the suit while the outside remained fine? I don't know. You don't seem to know much about him. Well, we haven't been traveling together that long. He rescued me off of this cargo freighter I was working on, and then we went to Greenland and a few other places, and now we're here. This one trip he promised me has turned into a lot more. Well, you both saved my station, though, so thank you for that. No problem. It's what we do. I just hope nothing like this ever happens again. Listen, the present I got my wife was in that shop.
I understand, sir. You can get your belongings back when we've given the all clear. Now please make your way to the main hall.
Dad, we should do what he says.
You go ahead if you want, Artie, but I'm staying here to get your mother's gift back.
Mr. Cooper, please follow your son back. This area is off-limits until further notice, and I don't want to have to detain you for being unruly.
I'd like to see you try.
Paul, come help me with this guy, will ya?
Yeah, Polly, why don't you try to arrest me?
I don't think there's much we can do right now. Why don't you go sit down for a few minutes? I'll watch over him.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, how's it going?
Terrible. My dad and I came here to pick up something from my mom, and now all of this happened.
Sorry to hear that. Where is he?
Arguing with some mall cop. Who's your friend in the med bay? I'm not actually really sure.
What's happening? I'm not sure. What's the nurse? He's not breathing.
Whoa, don't do that. You'll kill him. Do it like this.
Oh, wow, does that feel better?
How'd you know that'd work?
My mom has two hearts. She made the family take a special CPR class so we'd know what to do if she ever needed to be revived.
Huh, handy.
My name is Artie. Yours?
Dave. Nice to meet you, Artie.
Come on, you stupid lights. Work!
I've placed all the correct circuits.
Ah, there we go.
Well, I feel great. Thanks for the help, kid. That was just what I needed. A little cardiac reset. Whew. Still not sure about this voice, though.
I'm confused. Why do you look different?
Well, that's quite simple.
We demand to speak to who is in charge.
Yes, hello, that's me.
We will be emptying all currency boxes at vaults. Everything comes to us.
A robbery? Are you serious?
If you do not comply, the station will be obliterated.
Yes, hello. Now, what was that about a robbery?
We will have all currency on this station, or it shall be obliterated.
Really? I can't have a moment's rest, can I? I just regenerated! Give me a break. Why do you want the money here?
We serve the Fourth Galactic Cartel. They will have currency.
Drugs. No matter what year it is, drugs are always causing a problem.
You have 1 hour to surrender and open the vaults. If you choose not to, this station will be destroyed, and whatever currency remains will be collected.
Now, you listen here. You threaten anyone here, and you answer to me. No one here gets hurt. Not a single one.
surrender, and pain will not be necessary. 1 hour.
That was my dad. What was my dad doing with them? He's not a part of any cartel.
No, kiddo, he's not. I don't think any of them are. The glowing red eyes? That's evidence of something or other controlling them. But, if I had to guess, some little robot got a hold of one of them and is controlling the rest via some sort of mental field.
Okay, Doctor, how do we stop them?
Stop them? You heard what they said. If we try and retaliate, they'll destroy the station.
That's just talk. Strolling in here like that is backup. They try to destroy this station with a meteor attack, and these things are just bluster trying to scare us.
Well, I'm scared.
Don't be. There isn't anything they can do to hurt us.
Reactor core critical. 1 hour to detonation.
Or they can.
Okay, how'd they get access to the reactor?
Well, it seems like several of our security guards were in that group. I would have access to it for maintenance reasons.
Okay, so now we need to worry. Any ideas?
Well, if I had my sonic, I could just turn the robots off and we wouldn't have a problem, but it's not on me.
Where is it?
And where were the rest of my clothes, for that matter?
When we pulled you out of the hazmat suit, you weren't wearing any.
Oh, wonderful. The regeneration energy got trapped inside the suit and burned everything up, including the sonic. Theoretically speaking, if I had the right tools, I could jury-rig something together that might work like a sonic and send a shutdown signal to the robots.
This is assuming that they are robots in the first place. What if it's something else?
Then I don't know what's going on. We're on trouble. So, we go with what we can. Let's say that these robots are robots, and you could make something to shut them down. What kind of parts do you need?
Computer chips, some sort of tube, an emitter to send a signal, a couple other things.
Mr. Anom, is there anything like that we could use?
Well, computer terminals, torches, and stores might be right.
Grab everything you can.
Dave and Artie go in one direction. Mr. Anom, you go in another.
Where will you be going?
Shopping.
You! Yes, all of you. Don't worry about a thing. I'm going to save you, and you'll all be home in time for supper. Because that's what I do. Just make sure you stay out of the way and don't try to be heroes. You got that? Excellent.
Okay, we've got computer chips, different kinds of wireless transceivers, torches. Now all we need is me.
You're looking better.
Feeling better. Now, what do we have here?
Oh, this'll do nicely. Everyone, get ready.
Your time has expired. Will you be allowing us to access your currency?
No, I won't.
Then you will perish.
Oh, I don't think so. See, you and your cartel mates made a mistake when you tried robbing this place.
And what is that?
You didn't account for me.
Who are you?
Your worst nightmare.
An off switch!
Artie?
They're all right!
Reactor meltdown in 5, 4, 3. Override. Reactor stabilized. Station integrity at 100%.
He did it!
Of course he did. He's the doctor.
Doctor who, though?
Isn't that the question? And everyone is once again safe and sound. You're welcome, everybody.
Oh, my head.
Yeah, you got a giant gaping wound in the back of your neck from where the robot drilled and attached itself to your nervous system. No bleeding, though. It cauterized the wound for you, so at least it was polite.
Doctor, I can't thank you enough. You've saved my station twice today.
It's not a problem. It's what I do. Although, I think the time's come for Dave and I to head out.
Get the door for me, would you, Dave?
Sure.
Who were those two?
I have absolutely no idea.
What happened?
Oh my, you're upside down. Terribly sorry about that. The teleporter must have short-circuited.
Anom, where am I?
You're in my museum. An artifact such as yourself was too good an opportunity to pass up.
Where's Dave?
I have someone looking after him. He is safe, I assure you.